a dense, forbidden jungle at the bottom of Rainbow Pond, and a dark cave where no one dares to go. No one, that is, except the bullfrog known as the Don of the Pond, Pookie's father, Leopold.
Bruto, I swear to you, I've not been doing any pilfering.
Your tribute to me has been much smaller lately. I don't know if I can trust you anymore.
Honest, I never done nothing like that.
Don't interrupt me while I'm chastising you for pilfering, or I'll gobble you down like a bug, and then I'll find someone else to run the rackets in Rainbow Pond. Do you understand me?
Oh, please don't do anything like that, Bruto.
All right. Bring me twice as much tribute as usual sometime today or tomorrow. Otherwise... You heard me. I said I want twice as much tribute as usual. Otherwise...
Okay, Bruto, you got it.
Meanwhile, in another part of the pond, the children were frolicking happily, unaware of the monster catfish living in the cave in the forbidden jungle. Pookie had made an interesting discovery, and she was showing it to Jonathan, whose eyes were wide with wonder.
What's it called?
It's called a mirror, I think, Jonathan.
Is that really me in there? Yuck! Well, what do you know?
Jonathan, is this the first time you've ever seen how you look?
Yes, why don't you look in it?
Me? What was that?
Huh? I'll go and check it out.
Oh, please be careful, Jonathan.
Put that back. How can we make a living if you take everything we have and give it to Leopold, you hoodlum?
Well, take care of him, boys.
Hey, cut it out.
Papa, Papa.
Jonathan.
You big fat bully. I'll show you.
My little boy.
Now you listen to me. Anybody who doesn't want to pay their legal tribute to Boss Leopold is going to get the same, understand? Come on, boys, let's get out of here.
Looks like it was worth coming to Rainbow Pond. Maybe we can cut ourselves in.
Jonathan, won't you please talk to me? It isn't my fault that my papa is being mean. Aren't you and I friends anymore?
You're no better than he is. You didn't try to help.
But what could I do against Zari? He works for my papa, not me.
You can tell your papa to leave the other frogs alone.
Oh, Jonathan, I will tell him. And I just know he'll turn over a new leaf and start being nice to other frogs.
Booey.
Well, young frog, you seem to be very angry about something.
Huh? I don't think I know you.
We are the friends of frogdom. All.
Yeah, we travel around to the different ponds chastising all the rascals.
Really? You do?
We're missionaries of the great frog whose mission is to protect the weak from villains.
Yeah, we're like that Robin Toad who takes from the rich and gives to the poor.
You really think you could do something about reforming Leopold?
Of course we can. But there's one guy we gotta get rid of first. That Zari, Leopold's number one hit lobster.
Maybe you'd be able to lure him out into the open.
Absolutely. Nothing to it. Are you missionary sure that you can bring peace to Rainbow Pond?
Why, certainly, my boy. We've never lied to you, have we? At least since we've known you, that is.
Yeah,
I don't get it. Why should a tree frog want to give me a present?
I just thought you would become friendlier if I gave you a present.
Well, don't think this is going to make pals out of you and me, see?
Oh, no, Zari.
Because I don't make pals with no tree frog, see?
Course not. Look, we're almost there. Doesn't it look delicious?
Oh, yeah? Well, it don't look so hot to me.
You haven't even tried it yet.
This had better be good, Squirt, or I'm gonna make you sorry that you was ever born. I'm gonna get you for this.
Oh, yeah? Well, I gotta beat it now, Zari. Bon appetit!
Did the great frog bless our endeavor, Jonathan?
Yeah! He sure did!
Well done, Tad. I told you Zari wasn't very swift in the IQ department. Now we got him out of the way for good.
About as swift as Jonathan?
Yeah! Our friend Jonathan has saved the day.
I beg you, Papa, in Frog's name. Papa?
I guess I'll think about it.
I thought you were going to start being nice to the frogs here in the pond. Why should they have to pay us?
It ain't my fault what Zari does.
But Zari works for you. Oh, Papa, don't lie to me.
Pokey, how can you say that to your own Papa? Don't you trust me anymore?
I don't know how I can when we always have so much. And everyone else has so little. Why?
Now, Pookie Wookie. Zari, I'll get to the bottom of this. Where is that guy? I'll skin him alive. I'll fracture him. I'll murder the bum. I tell you, he'll never work again in this pond. Never. I'm gonna take care of that fella now, Pookie. Yeah, Zari knows how to collect. Oh, this is lovely. Lovely. I just wish I didn't have to give the biggest chunk of it to Bruto. Maybe I'll get lucky and he'll choke on it. Hey, what the? Oof. Help! Jonathan, my friend, help me.
You're just getting a taste of your own medicine.
Jonathan, I always liked you.
Good. Now I'll just take Leopold's loot and give it back to the people who rightfully own it. Oh!
No dice. The loot stays right here with us.
What? What did you say?
From now on, me and my pals pick up all the loot from Rainbow Pond.
You can't do that. You guys will never be able to take over the rackets in Rainbow Pond.
Huh? What do you mean by that crap?
Huh? Nothing.
Yeah, you better start talking.
Take it easy, Axel. I'll handle this guy. Come on, big shot. Talk.
You're choking me. Okay, I'll talk. I tried not to tell you this, but I'm not the boss of Rainbow Pond.
Huh?
I'm only an administrator. All this time I've been collecting the tribute for somebody else, you know? I've been a benefactor to all the citizens of Rainbow Pond to protect them from somebody else.
Yeah? Who else?
Well, if you must know, the real boss is Bruto the Great.
Bruto the Monster?
What? You mean Bruto lives in Rainbow Pond? Answer me, you jerk!
He lives in the Forbidden Jungle.
Take us there!
Yeah. Bruto will eat us all if we go in there.
You're gonna take us to Bruto whether you want to or not.
Oh.
Biff and Ron and I want to meet him. Go on.
What are you guys, nuts or something? Hey, cut it out, you guys! Help, Jonathan!
Come on, Biff. I guess we'll just have to persuade this guy.
Yeah, he's hard to convince.
Hey, you guys, let go of me. You're tearing my rope.
Well, you guys are no better than he is. I'll show you.
You want to... Want to see it again?
Are you all right, Jonathan? Oh, are you all right, Jonathan? Jonathan? What happened? Where is my papa? You know, Jonathan?
Did they get away? Oh.
Did who get away? My goodness, Jonathan, I just asked you if you knew where my papa is, that's all.
What? Your papa? Well, you see, I wanted to make your papa give back the stuff that Zari took. So I met these fellas and...
Huh? Who are these fellas?
The ones who made him take them to the Forbidden Jungle to meet Bruto the monster catfish.
Jonathan, why? How could you do a thing like this? You brought someone here who frognapped my papa, and now you say they're forcing him to go to the Forbidden Jungle? What have we done to you that you could treat us this way, Jonathan? Jonathan? Why won't you answer me?
I can't, Pookie.
What do you mean? Oh, I think you're terrible. You give me my papa back right now. Do you hear me?
I can't tell he's a crook. All right, I'll go and help him. Wait here. Hi.
Jonathan?
The Forbidden Jungle, you're kidding. Goodbye.
I really feel for you, kid, but uh-uh.
Oh, will you please help us look?
Won't you please help us search for our little Tad?
Oh, please.
I'd really love to help, but you know about my bad back, don't you?
Nobody cares about that, Leopold, anyhow.
Sorry. I got a family to support.
Very well, then. If you won't help us, we'll have to go alone. And may the great frog forgive you all. Come along, my dears. We'll find our loved ones without their help.
And with a courage born of desperation, the pitiful little group set out in search of Jonathan and Leopold, their hearts heavy with the knowledge that their fellow frogs could refuse to help in their desperate quest. They pressed on nonetheless.
It's my fault that Jonathan is lost. If not for me, he'd be safe at home right now.
Oh, nonsense, my child. Jonathan is responsible for his own impulsiveness. Why, Frog knows you had nothing to do with bringing those villains to your father's home. You mustn't blame yourself, Pookie. Now, the important thing is for us to just keep going.
Whoa, Mr. Hopper, do you really plan on entering the Forbidden Jungle?
What?
Ain't a fitting place for Frog nor Tadpole. My advice would be to get while the getting's good.
Thanks, Mr. Carp. But I've got to locate my son.
Oh, beware the lair of the anti-frog, the Forbidden Jungle. How does the old poem go? No matter how slick a frog may be, or however a powerful swimmer, if he enters the Forbidden Jungle by night, he too can be Bruto's dinner.
But we're not going by night.
Well, it don't matter none to Bruto.
Beware.
Oh, what's that?
Oh, please come back, Jonathan.
Oh, Jonathan.
At the moment that the intrepid little band hovers indecisively on the outer fringe of the Forbidden Jungle, what of Jonathan? Deep within the roaring maelstrom, our hero stands stalwartly before the entrance of the deep cavern that is the home to the monster, Bruto.
So it is your ambition to rule Rainbow Pond, is it? And you three would take Leopold's place in gathering tribute for Bruto the Great.
Yes, Your Magnificence, as you can see by the many gifts which we have already gathered to present to Your Honor.
That ain't so. I gathered all this stuff myself. Listen, Bruto, these street guys are a bunch of phonies.
Pipe down!
I've been thinking of replacing the inefficient Leopold as the gatherer of my tribute for a long time.
Don't say that.
I guarantee that we'll bring twice as much tribute as Leopold ever did, Your Eminence.
Yes, I think you are the right ones to control things here.
But what about me, sir?
We really have to go. We're gonna be rich as Rockefeller.
But no fooling now, Bruto. What's gonna happen to me, huh?
I guess I'll munch on you with the rest of this stuff.
You what? You munch on me?
Well, it's now or never.
Yeah, help! Help! Jonathan!
Another intruder, eh? He looks delicious.
Yeah, hey, that's a great idea. Why don't you eat Jonathan instead of me? A young frog is bound to be better tasting than an old frog.
Huh? What are you saying, Leopold, after I came here to try and rescue you?
How can you be so selfish, Jonathan? After all, I got my poor little Pookie to worry about and see that she's raised properly.
Be silent, you miserable squirming wretch, because it doesn't really matter anyhow, because I intend to devour you both.
All right, you guys, listen to me. Starting today, me and Biff and Rod are gonna start running all the rackets in Rainbow Pond instead of Leopold. You got any questions? Hey, what's happening?
Yeah.
Help, please.
That's enough.
Stop! Tickles! That was very clever, Jonathan, but you're still going into my stomach.
Oh.
Responsible for rocking my kingdom.
That.
Who has dared to bomb me?
Well, sir, it's obviously the work of those three guys that just left here. They brought a great monster over from another pond to take your place as ruler.
What? A monster to take my place? I'll show everybody who is the master of Rainbow Pond. Just show me where to find this great beast.
He's hiding in the inlet.
He is, eh? Just let me at him. He won't survive another hour.
Come on, let's get out of here.
Jonathan, I don't think I can make it unless you help me. I'm paralyzed with fear. My legs have turned to jelly.
Oh, all right.
Monster, muscle in on my turf, huh? There he is now. What an ugly looking jerk. All right, wise guy, what do you want? If you're looking for trouble, you really came to the right place. You understand what I'm telling you? Well, why don't you answer me? Too terrified, huh? Boy, is he ugly. Come on, let's see what kind of monster you are. Are you ready? Ready or not, here I come. Ow! Ooh! Well, I guess that bum won't bother nobody no more.
Hey, look, there's Bruto. Hey, Bruto, did you feel that earthquake?
Wise guy, huh? Say your prayers, punk. They were absolutely delicious. Who would ever have suspected? Scrumptious.
Help! Let go of me! I'll murder you, you bum! Let go of me! If I get my claws on you, I'll tear you apart.
Hold on, Zari. I'm coming. Old Leopold's coming to rescue you, pal. Don't worry about it. Just hang in there, pal.
Get me off of this. Somebody's going to pay for this. I'm telling you. Somebody's really going to get hurt.
Huh?
Well, looks like we got something.
Hey, there's a human person up there.
What?
I'll help you.
Let's just see what we've got here.
No.
Well, whatever it was, it sure got away. Better luck next time. I guess I'll have to buy a pound of hamburger on the way home.
I'd better look for Leopold. He'll soon come crawling back with more tribute if he knows what's good for him. Perhaps I was a little hasty, threatening to eat him. But the terrified expression on his face when he thought he was going to be eaten was absolutely irresistible. Somebody's coming this way. Funny looking old creep. Guess I should duck. Mustn't let anyone see me.
What kind of a gall-darn chili plant's that?
Oh, no. The old fool is coming this way.
Well, I swan if that ain't the gall-darnedest, stubbornest plant I ever seen. You spoils the look of the whole neighborhood. Huh? Blamed if it don't even sound ugly. But I know what to do to kill it. Oh! Well, I reckon I'll go easy on it. And just let it stay right there. Sometimes you gotta show a little charity.
Perhaps someday I shall sink my teeth in one of your whiskers, my little friend. Well, what have we here? What a delectable little serving of hors d'oeuvres. And they're coming this way. Don't they look tasty? With so many wonderful things to eat, it certainly isn't easy to stay undercover. But if everyone finds out about me, they'll all leave the pond and move to another one. Being the master of the pond is a dirty job, but somebody has to do it. Confounded tree frog brat that came to rescue Leopold. I ought to devour him right now, but I can't risk anyone else seeing me.
Oh, I know it's you, Pookie.
Guess what? I brought you some nice cookies.
Oh, boy, I really like your cookies.
I hope you like them. I baked them for you especially.
I think these are about the best cookies I ever tasted, Pookie.
How can she waste such goodies on that wretched little tree frog, Jonathan, when I also desire and hunger for the good things in life?
I can also cook and clean house and sew and give a good back rub too, Jonathan.
What remarkable talent.
When I grow up, I'll be married and I'll make a very good wife. Maybe I'll even marry you if you would like to, Jonathan.
Huh?
Uh-oh, I don't like the sound of that at all. I've got to figure out a way to get rid of that cheeky little tree frog. The girl frog would make fine company in my cave if I can discover a way to dispose of Jonathan.
Pookie.
What is it, Jonathan?
Pookie, do you respect your father?
Well, of course I do, Jonathan. Why do you ask?
How would you feel if you knew he was involved in something crooked?
Well, I know he would never get involved with anything like that, so I don't even have to concern myself with the thought. You think he's bad because he doesn't like you, but he will when he gets to know you better.
Oh.
Try to look at his side of things once in a while.
Yes, I guess you're right. Okay.
Beautiful pond is good place to grow tads. If I am throwing eggs in water, maybe they are growing up big and strong like Tiger Jaw. Here you go, little teddy balls. Nice fresh pond. I think you're gonna like it here, eh? Huh? What is this coming? It looks like snake. Look out, little teddy balls. Where tadpoles go? It's great monster. Oh, monster, please don't eat up Tiger Joe.
Oh, for Pete's sake, pipe down, will you?
What are you going to do with my little daddy paws, Mr. Catfish Monster?
These puny things don't even give me an appetite. You look like a bullfrog to me. What are you doing with these eggs?
These eggs are from Froggy Orphanage for taking to my wife some little tads, and they could grow up strong and big in this little pond, but I am not knowing there is monster giant catfish living here, so I am hoping you will give them back to me, oh great one.
There might be a way you could pay for their return. You have a powerful frogly physique, and if you'll do a service for me, I'll give your eggs back, all right?
I am happy for to do whatever you want, Your Majesty.
I have an enemy named Jonathan. Now, here's what I want you to do.
Listen, Bruto, it ain't very smart for you to come to the surface like that. I mean, the first thing you know, somebody will spot you, and then everybody will clear out of the pond, you know what I mean? Then what happens to your tribute? Tell me that.
I guess you're right, although having to exist day after day in a lonely dark lair is starting to get on the nerves.
You just gotta be patient for a little while till I figure out something. After all, Jonathan knows about you, and you know what that means.
You needn't concern yourself with Jonathan. I arranged a solution to that while you were sulking over our previous misunderstanding.
What kind of solution?
All that is necessary for you to know is that Jonathan is getting taken care of.
Yeah, but I want you to promise me that you'll stay out of sight from now on so that nobody else finds out about you and me doing business, Bruto.
Just as you say, old friend, I'll stay right in here, out of sight.
Boy, that's a load off my mind.
Just one thing.
Yeah?
It's boring here, and often I feel the need for conversation.
Can't say I blame you.
Good. Then you won't mind bringing your daughter down here to live with me from now on.
What? You want my little Pookie to come down here to live?
Certainly you wouldn't refuse my little request just when we were getting along so well, would you?
Anything but that, Bruto.
I say you will do as you're told if you know what's good for you. Understand?
You don't understand. She loves Jonathan.
I told you not to concern yourself with that. Jonathan is being taken good care of. Jonathan's going to be mangled. My new wrestler will see to that.
That wrestler is just too soft-hearted to do anything to Jonathan.
What? You mean that traitor dares to defy me? He'll learn the price of treason. I'll eat his eggs.
Wait, you mustn't do it. If you don't give the restless eggs back to him, he'll tell everybody in the pond about you, and then they'll all leave here.
Yes, and your henchmen will flee too, leaving you to face the people you've cheated. Now, will you bring your daughter to keep me company?
I'll talk to her.
As soon as you bring her to me, then you can return these eggs to that treasonous, backstabbing wrestler.
I didn't say that I would bring Pookie here. I just said that I'd talk to her.
If you don't do as I order, I'll come to the surface and devour everyone in sight.
Oh, please have mercy.
What? You squall for mercy? Have you ever considered my feelings, you selfish, miserable, overblown windbag? You had better bring Pookie to me before I make up my mind to murder everybody in Rainbow Pond.
Okay, anything you say, anything.
Having overheard the plot to make her the prisoner of the monster, Pookie flees blindly from the cave in the Forbidden Jungle. Meanwhile, a short distance away, Jonathan and his family are quietly at work and totally unaware of the terrible threat to the unfortunate girl. Leopold, however, has left the monster's cave and is frantically searching for his beloved daughter.
Pookie. Yoo-hoo, Pookie. Oh, Pookie.
Go away.
Where are you?
Go away and leave me alone.
Hmm? Pookie, dear, what's the matter with you? Why are you crying? Pookie.
Oh, get away from me. I despise you.
Huh? But, Pookie, I'm your papa. You know that you don't despise me. You always love me.
Not anymore.
Huh? But, Pookie.
I overheard your conversation with that dreadful catfish.
Oh.
You're a very wicked frog, the most wicked frog in the pond.
Oh, come on.
Can you imagine how you've made other frogs suffer and all for nothing?
Well, don't blame me. I had to do what that Bruto said. Otherwise, he would have killed me and had me for dinner.
Then it was only because you're just a big coward. Oh, I'm so ashamed. I don't know how I can face anybody in the pond from now on.
Oh, Pookie, won't you please forgive me? Oh, I just can't stand it when you cry. Why don't we just pack up and leave Rainbow Pond?
Leave?
We could go someplace else and make a brand new start. What do you say? Oh, Pookie.
We were forgetting about the rustler's eggs. If we move out of Rainbow Pond, the catfish will devour all the little tads immediately.
I know that, and believe me, I'm terribly sorry about that bunch of mini tads, but you know, before long, Bruto would be getting ideas about eating you, and I couldn't bear that.
Even as the plucky little frog boy is stealing out of Bruto's cave with the wrestler's eggs, Pookie and her father are bidding a forlorn farewell to Rainbow Pond, for Leopold's terror of the catfish monster remains undiminished.
Bye, Jonathan.
And so they turn from the only home Pookie has ever known to begin a life of exile and disgrace. His shoulders bowed in shame, the once proud Don of Rainbow Pond flees with a few pitiful possessions and the knowledge that he is leaving his neighbors to the mercy of a merciless adversary, his only thought being for his own safety.
Good morning, Mr. and Ms. Frog. It's wonderful morning now for good swim, da?
Oh, my! How did you get your eggs back from Bruto?
It was very heroic thing. Young Froggy got its eggs back from monster catfish and they hatch very soon after.
What young frog could do that?
There, look! Is fine young frog Jonathan who is hero and is saving its little daddy Paul.
My Jonathan!
How come you're packed and everything, Pookie? Are you going somewhere?
Yes, we're going away from Rainbow Pond and find someplace else to make a home because of our shame.
She means because of my shame, Jonathan. I'm a disgrace to Frogdom, and I'm to blame for everything that happened.
Mm-mm. The one to blame is Bruto.
Why, Jonathan?
Well, he's the one who was forcing your papa to pay tribute to him so he wouldn't run amok and devour everyone.
Yeah, but we still have to leave.
Why don't we all get together and drive that monster out of the pond?
It's no use. Nobody will forgive me.
Sure they will. Just remember, Pookie is my friend, and that makes you my friend, and that's the way most frogs feel about it. After all, friends should help each other.
Jonathan, I'll do anything I can to help.
Oh, Papa, you sound like a new frog.
It's very good.
Bye, Tiger. Come back to the Rainbow Pond soon.
Bye.
Goodbye, my friends. Da svidaniya.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Come back soon. Goodbye, Tiger.
Bye.
Let's have a brand new start then. What do you say? Now that we're all pals again, we're gonna have to stick together. And we're not gonna do what Bruto says no more. We're gonna find a way to outsmart him and make this pond a decent place to live for all frog kind from this moment on. All this I swear. So help me, frog.
And so Jonathan is reunited once more with Pookie and her father. And for a little while, they can bask in the warmth of their newfound friendship before facing the dread wrath of the monster, Bruto. The surface of Rainbow Pond always looks peaceful and beautiful. And the little creatures who dwell there are secure in their belief in a great frog who keeps them safe from harm. Indeed, most of them have no suspicion that their idyllic existence could ever be threatened by any outside influence. And on a day like today, even those who know better sometimes forget. While happy families swim together among the flowers and the lily pads, there are three who are aware that the ghastly anti-frog lurks deep beneath the tranquil waters. But Pookie and Leopold, being only frogly, are enjoying this beautiful day.
I'm so glad we didn't leave here. We'll all live happily ever after, won't we, Papa?
Yeah, well, if the frogs in Rainbow Pond will forgive me for making them pay the tribute that I was given to Bruto.
Oh, I'm sure they will, Papa. The frogs in Rainbow Pond aren't mean when they understand the situation.
When they understand? How can they understand? When they find out about Bruto, they'll all run for their lives. Then the pond will be empty.
I don't believe that, Papa. I think they'll all stay and fight.
It's my responsibility. I gotta defend all frog kind.
Oh, Papa dear, I'm so proud that you become so heroic and brave.
Thank you, Pookie. I'm so sorry. Well, you know, but I'm gonna be a new frog starting right now.
What's the matter, Jonathan? You're so quiet. Are you sick of something?
Huh? Uh-uh.
Did you have another quarrel with Pookie?
Mm-mm. Nope.
Was Leopold picking on you again?
Oh, no. That has nothing to do with it.
You're just being nice. I know what kind of a frog he is.
Papa, it really makes me angry to hear you speak badly of Pookie's father.
Why, Jonathan, what on earth's come over you this morning?
I'm afraid that our little boy has allowed his affection for Pookie to stand in the way of his judgment of Leopold.
Leopold said that we'd all be friends. Him, too.
What? Leopold? Do you believe that, Mother?
He's my friend!
Leopold has conned you again. He's making a fool out of you. Don't you know that?
Oh, no! It's all because of Bruto.
What?
It's nothing. I gotta go now.
Do you really think it's true that Leopold wants Jonathan to be his friend?
Of course not. Leopold? That frog will never be anything but a cheap gun toad.
I couldn't tell them the real reason why I'm worried. They think it's because of Leopold. But it doesn't matter whether he's my friend or not. Because when Bruto finds out he's not getting any more tribute, he'll run amok. If that happens, everybody will run away from here and Rainbow Pond will be deserted. Boy, that makes me mad. Nobody has any right to do that. I'll fix that big brute. Huh? Hey.
What you doing here, Jonathan? You waiting for somebody or what?
If it's Pookie you're waiting for, I understand she's sick and ain't gonna go to school today.
Huh?
Don Leopold don't want Pookie to be seen with you anyway, because tree frogs ain't fit company for her.
He did not say that.
How can you be so certain?
Because I know that Pookie's father is a gentle frog.
Flattery won't get you anyway, you little jerk.
He'll never let Pookie have anything to do with a tree frog.
You two clowns don't know anything about it.
We do know that it's fun to beat up on a certain smart-aleck little tree frog.
Yeah.
No! You big bully! Huh? Why, you...
Has it escaped your notice that Jonathan just called you a catfish?
What? Call me a catfish, will you? I'll murder you. I'll pulverize you. Hey, let go of me, for frog's sake. This little punk just called me a catfish.
Huh?
Mr. Leopold.
What's the big idea, picking on this little frog? I ought to marry you both.
But, sir, we thought that since this was Jonathan...
Yeah, you always said that we
should... Shut up when I'm giving you a lesson in the proper manners for you to become a gentle frog.
But the only thing that me and Lefty did was...
Beat it, punk.
Yes, sir. Come on, Mo, before he hoits somebody.
Are you all right, Jonathan?
Yeah.
Those are really rotten kids.
It's all right.
You're a good tad.
Is Pookie really very sick?
Well, she was kind of worried about the catfish monster, so I told her it was okay if she stayed home from school today.
I certainly can't say I blame her for that.
Well, seems like everything's all right here, I reckon.
Uh-oh!
Sorry!
What?
Hi, guys.
Calvin and Derek, what are you doing here?
Well, Zari, you look very prosperous.
Indeed, yes. And may I say it's a great source of satisfaction to me to see a friend doing so well in his chosen profession.
Well, with all due modesty, I must confess that I have done rather well as the personal bodyguard of the great Don Leopold.
We've heard that this Mr. Leopold is the local frog father and that he runs all the rackets worth looking into in Rainbow Pond. Is that correct?
The word is over in Lobster Lagoon that he might be hiring extra help. And we thought that with our old pal Zari being on the inside, as it were, that you might put in a good word for us with Mr. Leopold. What do you say?
Well, why not? Mr. Leopold's a reasonable man. No reason why he shouldn't want a couple more good claws.
Precisely my thinking.
I can't help feeling sorry for poor Jonathan, being that he knows all about Bruto and he can't say nothing to nobody about him. Listen, Pookie, I've been thinking of blowing the whistle on Bruto and maybe ratting on him to all the other frogs living here in Rainbow Pond.
Oh, Papa, you really mustn't. If the people knew about Bruto, it would only start a terrible panic.
Well, I just can't sit around doing nothing.
Excuse me, Mr. Leopold. I have a couple of friends to present to you, sir, if you have a moment. Some of the frogs here in Rainbow Pond have been a little slow lately in coughing up their tribute, and I thought that you could use a couple of extra claws to make them jar loose, quicker.
Nah, I don't need the likes of these guys. What are you bringing mugs around here for?
I don't get it. You're always complaining that there's not enough claws around here.
Well, I changed my mind. I just can't give a job to every bum who comes around here.
Okay. Anything you say.
I must say your attitude is not at all what we were led to expect, Mr. Leopold.
Yeah, who you calling a bum?
Would you rather be called boy or lobster? Now get out of my house!
But...
Yes, very reasonable fellow, Mr. Leopold.
I can't figure out what's wrong with him.
I know what's gonna be wrong with him the next time I run into the punk. Come on, Derek. Let's get out of this joint. What do we need with an overweight bullfrog, anyway?
I'm not gonna forget this. Hey, what the?
Yai, now what the blazes is going on? It's an earthquake. Hey. That's gotta be a call from Bruto.
Are you aware of what has occurred here? A heinous wretch of low degree has dared to intrude on the sanctity of these quarters and has stolen away with the eggs of my dear friend Tiger Joe.
Who would dare to steal something from you?
What'd you say?
I was just wondering out loud who would dare to come in here and try to steal something from your eminence.
That's exactly the reason I called you here, understand?
How would I know anything about anybody who was nuts enough to steal from you? Maybe the Tad's just hatched and swam away.
That's hardly likely. Now you just listen and do as you are ordered. I want you to retrieve those eggs, and also to get your daughter down here at once. Do you understand?
Yes, but...
Yes, but what?
Well, that is...
I'm not going to argue with you. You have your orders. Now go and do as you're told, or I'll eat you right now.
Mr. Leopold? Why are you looking so downhearted?
Oh, Jonathan, the catfish monster said that I gotta bring Pookie to him today or suffer the consequences.
What?
That means he'll eat everybody in the pond if I don't do it.
That horrible monster. He can't just keep getting away with that kind of stuff. No matter what, you can't take Pookie to him.
Oh, I don't know what I'm gonna do, Jonathan. I know that I can't take Pookie to him, but what else can I do when he says that he's gonna eat everybody in Rainbow Pond if I don't obey him?
Oh, how could anybody be so vicious and rotten? We'll just have to think about it.
I hope you can think of something.
I'm going to leave now. I'll miss you both. I've decided to go to the catfish monster, Papa, before he becomes a danger to everyone in the pond. Sooner or later, he could run amok, and I can't permit that to happen.
No, Pookie, not you.
You can't! Pookie, you just can't do it!
What other choice do I have, Jonathan, when he says he'll eat everybody in the pond if I don't go?
But he may decide to eat you. It's just too dangerous.
He would probably eat me in any case. This way gives me some time to plan. Don't you agree that I'm right, Papa?
Oh, my poor Pookie.
Please don't worry about it, Papa. I just know that you and Jonathan will figure out some way of rescuing me.
Oh, I still think Pookie shouldn't be allowed to go.
Oh, Jonathan, there is no other way to appease the monster.
No.
Jonathan, please understand.
No, no, I don't want you to go with that monster.
Jonathan, wait.
Unable to understand the gravity of the threat Bruto poses, Jonathan runs to another part of the pond. As always, when he is deeply troubled, he finds solace in playing his reed pipe. And as the music steals across the surface of his consciousness, the sharp pain in his heart becomes less, and the light of hope is rekindled.
Well, now what?
Not certain of what he intends to do or where he is going, the frog boy starts to run, until at last...
It's happening.
The thing he most dreads is indeed happening. A funeral procession is setting out from Leopold's house, bearing large shells filled with tribute. And leading the mournful troop is the Don's most precious possession, his beloved daughter, Pookie. With frogly dignity, the child is determined to sacrifice herself to protect the others in Rainbow Pond. All too soon, she is presented like a rare jewel to the horrible catfish monster, Bruto.
I can't tell you how happy it makes me to have old friends come to cheer me up in my loneliness here.
Yes.
This occasion is especially gratifying, since one of the visitors is to be my house guest for a while. Satisfy my curiosity, Pookie. Is it true that frog legs are absolutely delicious?
Pookie is my only child, Bruto. I beg you to treat her well and take good care of her, and she will obey your commands.
Why, certainly. As long as she does what I tell her, she has nothing at all to fear or be concerned with. But understand me, Pookie. If you should ever try to escape from here, I'll come after you and devour everyone in the pond.
I won't run away. I'll stay here just as long as you promise not to harm anybody.
Then I think we have a deal.
I guess it won't be too bad living here, but I sure wish that Jonathan was with me.
Pookie, hey. Pookie.
I thought somebody called me, like Jonathan. In fact, it sounded just like Jonathan. thing. Pookie, hey, Pookie.
Pookie, hey, Pookie.
Huh? What? Huh? Jonathan.
Hi, Pookie.
What are you doing?
Shh.
Jonathan, how did you manage to get down here?
You didn't think I'd leave you alone to live in such a scary place, did you?
Oh, Jonathan, my hero.
Now that I'm here with you, you don't have to worry about anything.
Right. I'm not afraid of anything right now.
That's not all. I'll find a way to lick Bruto, too.
Sure.
See you later.
All right, Jonathan.
Start talking.
How would I know where Jonathan is?
He was last seen with you. Mr. Karp saw you together. You must know where he is.
Well, I don't know.
You may fool Jonathan with sweet talk, but you're not kidding me.
I was never trying to fool Jonathan about anything.
Yeah, Leopold, you'd lie when the truth would sound better, you fat bum. You're gonna tell me where Jonathan and Pookie went, understand?
Yeah, maybe he has gone to try to save my little Pookie.
Wah!
Well, I guess I got no choice. I'm not really the boss here. The real boss is a catfish monster that lives at the bottom of the pond in a cave in the forbidden jungle. All the time I've been collecting tribute from the folks here in Rainbow Pond, it was never for me. I was collecting it for the monster Bruto. I'm really sorry.
That must be the thing Jonathan was talking about.
Yeah, and Jonathan has given me heart to fight against the catfish monster.
Is that true?
I swear.
Then I'm going to join you, Mr. Leopold. We'll fight the monster together. You won't be alone anymore, my friend.
Praise Frog.
We can't fall behind our children now, that's for sure.
You bet. We'll show them our stuff.
So he's gonna double-cross Bruto, eh? Well, what do you know? Maybe I can turn this bit of knowledge to my own advantage if properly employed.
Mr. Bruto, your dinner is ready to eat now. Yoo-hoo, Mr. Bruto, wake up!
Yeah, what is it? Oh, it's you, little one. Well, you and I are going to get along just fine with this kind of service.
Boy, what a blowhard!
What's that? Did you hear anything?
Oh, yes. It was me saying dinner was ready.
Ah, yes. How nice. I'm very hungry. Delicious. Marvelous.
Oh, somebody is coming this way, Mr. Bruto.
Pardon the intrusion, Mr. Bruto, but I must have a word with you, sir.
Well, what is it, sorry?
I regret to say that I'm here to report a terrible breach of your confidence.
What are you saying?
It's Leopold. He's plotting against you.
Leopold, he wouldn't dare.
You think that he's a faithful servant, but he's actually scheming to drive you out. He is a traitor, Mr. Bruto.
Who are you going to believe, me or him?
If Leopold is a traitor, as you say, why would he send his daughter to serve me?
The only reason he sent her here was to keep you off guard by distracting you. He's just buying time so he can... Well, look who's here. As I was saying, he's just buying time until he can figure out a way to drive you out.
You know he's lying, Mr. Catfish. He hasn't got a shred of evidence to prove what he's saying.
What proof do you have?
I'll show you proof.
What do you mean?
Here's proof.
Uh-oh.
They sent him to spy on you.
So it's you.
I guess now you'll believe me when I tell you they're conspiring against you.
So it's true.
Oh, Jonathan!
Shut up.
I'll teach you to spy on me.
Please don't hurt him.
I'll teach both of you a lesson.
Let me go, Zari.
No!
Hold on a minute, Mr. Bruto. You can eat them anytime you want to. I have a better idea. We can hold them as hostages and force the pond people to surrender.
That's not a bad idea, Zari. I guess you're smarter than Leopold after all.
Thanks. I'm willing to take his place as your assistant if you want me to. Okay?
Good. Now, how can I get back at Leopold?
I've taken care of that already. You'll never have to worry about Leopold again.
Huh? You are a fast worker, aren't you?
Yes.
No!
You too. Nice and cozy.
When I tell everyone how you've decided to reform, I'm sure they'll be willing to forget about your past, Leopold. They'll believe me.
I appreciate this, Mr. Hopper.
Think nothing of it, Leopold. After all, what are friends for? When it comes to being friends, Pookie and Jonathan are way ahead of us.
Say, listen, if I tell the pond people about the monster, they might panic and go find someplace else to live.
You know, I think you're right. Maybe we better not tell anybody until we figure out what to do about that monster catfish.
You're in trouble now, Leopold.
Huh? I don't know what you're talking about.
You see, Zari told the catfish monster how you double-crossed him.
That's right. And I wouldn't be surprised if the monster takes his revenge out on those kids of yours.
What?
Jonathan!
You know his appetite. The chances are that they're already inside his stomach.
I don't believe it.
Oh, yeah? See you, Leopold.
It's no use, Jonathan. Give up.
There's got to be some way out.
We'll never get out.
It would indeed be difficult to imagine a more hopeless situation for Pookie, for Jonathan, and for all the people of Rainbow Pond.
Sure knows how to make beautiful music. That's the most restful melody I've ever heard in my life. I can barely keep my eyes open.
Look, Pookie, my music is putting him to sleep. Now's our chance.
Now's our chance to do what, Jonathan?
Escape! This just might work.
Careful.
There. Now just wait till he wakes up. He'll pull the bar off for us.
I sure hope this works, because if it doesn't, he's sure gonna be awful mad at you, Jonathan.
I don't care what he does to me, as long as I can save your life, Pookie.
Oh, Jonathan.
Don't worry, Pookie. We'll be all right.
If you say so, Jonathan, I trust you.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Make a lot of noise so he'll wake up. Hey, Bruda, wake up! Whoa! Hold tight, Pookie, this is it! Any broken bones, Pookie?
No.
Okay, now swim as fast as you can.
Right.
You two think you're gonna get away? You know you can't get away. Why even try?
I'm never gonna make it, Jonathan. You better go ahead.
Come on, you can make it, Boogie.
Here, huh?
You better get away from here, here as fast as you can, Mo. The catfish monster is coming right behind us.
What?
Oh. Hurry, Pookie. We can hide in the seaweed.
Yeah.
In here, Mo. Hurry.
Oh no, he caught my father! That's my father! I gotta help
him! It's too late, Mo! It's too late to save him! You can't go!
My father.
Come on, Mo, we gotta hide!
Father? Oh! He ate my father! 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 Oh, I loved him!
Poor Mo.
This whole thing is your fault, Jonathan. If you hadn't stirred up the catfish monster and made him mad, he never would have left this cave, and then my daddy wouldn't have been eaten.
But...
it's your fault my daddy's gone, and now I'm going to make you pay for it, Jonathan.
No!
No! Stop it, Mo. Oh. You shouldn't blame Jonathan for what happened to your father.
I wish that catfish monster had eaten you instead of my dad.
Huh?
What's that?
What are you talking about? There's no catfish monster.
He's hysterical.
He was there and saw the whole thing happen. I guess he knows what he's talking about. Maybe there is a catfish monster.
There is a catfish monster on the loose. This pond isn't safe for anyone.
We better think about moving.
They're panicking just like Hopper said they would.
Don't hit him again, Mo. You'll kill him.
Poor Jonathan, he could be hurt bad. Please wake up. You took your grief out on him even though it wasn't his fault. I hope you're satisfied, Mo, and you'll leave him alone from now on.
You should try not to be angry with Mo, Pookie. He's been through an awful lot and he's out of his mind with grief. Just think how we would feel if we lost our fathers. Mo, if it'll make you feel any better, you can hit me again.
You folks aren't thinking about leaving the pond, are you?
Yep, I've never had the slightest desire to be eaten by a monster.
It may be true and it may not, but I'm telling you, I don't want to live in any pond where there's even a rumor about such a monster.
Mrs. Hopper was right. Mo was just hysterical with grief when he said that. I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a catfish monster. Am I right, Hopper? Tell him!
Let me put it this way. Has anyone here ever seen a monster?
You've lied to these people long enough, Leopold. It's time that they heard the truth. And the truth is, he's known about the catfish monster all along.
Don't listen to him. He's lying.
Furthermore, not only did Leopold know about the catfish monster, he was working for him.
He's lying, I tell you.
Papa!
You thought he was the big shot around here, but all the tribute he collected from you was turned over to the catfish monster in the Forbidden Jungle. He's been lying to everybody all along because he knew the real ruler of Rainbow Pond was the catfish monster, not him. He's a totally evil frog who betrayed all of you.
That's not true. I'm not evil. I've reformed, believe me.
Saying you're reformed is just like saying you're guilty.
That's right.
How do we know you're not still working for him?
You're wrong. Don Leopold has really decided to mend his ways, so we should all try to forgive him.
Just to prove to you who your real friend is, I'm going to tell you how to get rid of that catfish monster. Use Leopold as bait by tying him up outside the monster's cave.
Do what?
That'll draw the catfish monster out of his cave, and it'll also attract the dogfish, and they'll have a big fight, and they'll kill each other.
Yeah, but they'll kill me, too.
Sounds like a good plan to us.
Oh. No, Zari, you can't feed my father to the monster. Use me, please.
Oh, no.
My darling daughter.
They can't do this to you, Papa.
You want to hear the real truth? Sari's working for the monster. He wants to take over the pond for himself.
How do we know you're telling the truth, Jonathan?
Have I ever lied? Or have I?
I don't know.
I'll decide who to use for bait. Grab that kid.
Come on, punk.
Hey,
you
let go of me.
That's what you get for causing my father to be eaten by the monster.
Here he is, boss.
What about the girl, Zari? She even volunteered.
We'll just take both families. How's that?
Oh, this is all my fault. I'm sorry, everyone.
Jonathan?
I'm thinking.
I can't see any way out of this situation.
We just have to keep our faith.
That traitor Leopold told the pot people all about you, sir. But I'll take care of everything. I'll tell them that you and the dogfish killed each other.
You're smarter than Leopold ever was.
If the dogfish actually does show up, I know you can take care of him. Then everything can get back to normal, just like it used to be.
And getting back to normal means you'll be bringing me a steady supply of tributes, right?
Naturally, sir.
I'm glad we understand each other.
Yes, sir.
All squared away with Pluto?
Yeah, did the monster buy your story, boss?
Sure, it's just like he said. We understand each other.
Leopold, it looks like your number's up.
Leave us alone!
Now what shall I have for dinner? I suppose I should start with Leopold and the others that are tied up. Not enough food for a full meal, but they'll make fine hors d'oeuvres. This is my lucky day. Nothing tastier than dogfish.
You better let go, Pluto. I'm warning you.
Fish your fins get fine.
Oh, yeah. We'll just see about that. Want some more, catfish?
There won't be any more, dogfish, because when I get through with you, there won't be anything left at all.
What'll we do? They're coming right for us.
Hold on, Pookie. I'll think of something. No!
You better stay for dinner, dogfish. After all, what's a dinner without the main course?
Huh? There. That was a close one. Are you all right?
Wow, I sure am glad to see you.
I'm glad to see all of you. I mean all of you, with no pieces missing.
Thanks, Jerome.
Now let's go. We don't have much time.
Do you think they're all right? Yeah, this suspense is killing me.
If you think it's killing you, you should see what it's doing to them. They're goners, no doubt about it.
That's right, boss. You show them guys, boss. Just like you said you would.
They got just what they deserved. All of them.
What's that? Oh, no, it couldn't be. It is a frog-eating monster dogfish.
Frog legs.
Help! Somebody help me!
Moe's in danger.
Wait, it's too dangerous. No.
Go down there. You're done for. Let me go.
No, wait.
Jonathan.
I can't go much further.
Is he gone?
Yes, but for how long? He might.
This pond's
back.
Become too dangerous.
Yeah, who wants to live in a place where you're always scared? Oh, no!
Thanks.
There's no place to raise my family.
It's not a pond. It's not a pond. It's not a pond.
Too dangerous.
Wait! Hold on! You gotta listen to me! Stop!
No way.
Running away from our problems won't solve anything. The only solution is to stay and work together.
Jonathan's right. This pond is ours. It's our home.
We can make it like it used to be if we all fight them together.
Yeah, we'll show them.
Don't you see? We can't give up. If our home's not worth fighting for, what is? We've got to show these bullies that they can't... Go on, cowards, run. But once you start running, you won't be able to stop. But I'm staying right where I am. You'll have to run over me.
What's he doing?
And me.
Oh, you mean it?
I was wrong, Jonathan. Can we be friends?
We sure can.
I'm sorry for all the things I did.
Thanks, Mo.
Now I've seen everything.
The lad's convinced me. I'm staying, and that's final.
I'm with you.
Nobody's gonna make us leave Rainbow Pond. Come on.
Couldn't have said it better myself.
It's wonderful.
Yes, but the problem still exists. How are we going to get rid of the catfish monster?
I bet you Mr. Eel would help us. He hates Bruto as much as we do. In their last fight, Mr. Eel clobbered him.
Yeah, that's a fine idea. The problem is, he's out at sea. How could we possibly find him?
Simple aerial reconnaissance. I know that the ocean is terribly big, but you would be surprised at how much you can see from up in the air.
Keeper, you're a genius.
Quit sulking, Sari. I'll get those frogs sooner or later. You should be happy that I just had my favorite meal, dog meat.
I'm just concerned about your safety, Bruto, because of that Jonathan guy.
That shrimp? You must be kidding.
Now listen. You may be the biggest fish in Rainbow Pond, but what if you had to fight all the others at the same time? You think you could beat them?
What are you talking about? Those cowards wouldn't dare come after me.
They will if this guy Jonathan convinces them that they can beat you by combining forces. You get the picture?
So that's what the little sneak is up to. Well, I guess I'll just have to teach the locals another lesson to remind them whose territory this really is by showing them what happens to guys like Jonathan who forget. Next to dogfish, frog legs are my favorite food.
Mr. Eel will help us make Rainbow Pond the way it used to be. I know he will. Here we go.
Goodbye. Be careful, Jonathan.
It's up to you now, Jonathan.
Be careful, Jonathan. Good luck.
Bye, everybody. I'll come back as soon as I can. Goodbye, goodbye.
Meantime, in the forbidden jungle, Mo and Kyle cautiously approach the cave of the catfish monster, Bruto.
This is it. Yeah. You know, somehow this doesn't seem like such a good idea now that we're here.
Put your weapon and treat me. You acted just like a
lily-livered
coward. You know that?
Oh, yeah? Well, for your information, I'm not acting.
Come on, Bruto, you have to wake up. Come on. Come on, it's time for the attack to begin, and you're supposed to lead it.
Go away. When my stomach gets this full, I get so sleepy I can't wake up.
But you can't just back out on us now. If you want us to take over the pond, we're gonna need your help. I have a huge army standing by, just waiting for you.
If you have a huge army, you don't need me.
Come on, Bruto, wake up. If we're gonna catch everybody by surprise, we've gotta move fast. Well, it's easy to see he's not going to be any help. I guess I'll just have to lead the attack myself.
Did you hear that? He's planning a surprise attack.
Yeah, with a huge army.
We have to warn everyone and tell them to put together their own army. Come on, let's go, Lefty.
Hurry! I'm too scared to move.
Hey, what's that noise?
I thought you said somebody's out there. Yeah, wait for me, Mo. Wait for me.
Jonathan and his friend Cheaper make their way to the ocean to find Mr. Eel to seek his assistance in the fight against the catfish monster.
The ocean sure is big, Cheaper. I hope we can find him.
Just keep playing your flute. He may recognize the sound.
We need help, Ely.
I owe you a favor after all the help you gave me, so just tell me what you want and consider it done, Jonathan.
The catfish monster is threatening everybody in the pond, and we have to stop him.
He's too big for me.
I know, but we were hoping your father would help us out.
Sure he will.
He's out in the deep ocean right now, but I'm sure if I send him a message, he'll want to help.
Gee, thanks a lot, Ely.
He says he'll come back as quick as he can, and he'll meet us at the mouth of the river.
Great. He can take care of that monster.
We'd better hurry. Just follow me.
Right.
As Ely and Jonathan hurry to meet Mr. Eel, Zari has gathered his army to give them their invasion orders.
All right, you all know what to do. Show no mercy and take no prisoners. We want this pond all to ourselves by the time this battle is over.
Don't worry, Zari. Our claws are all sharpened and ready to be put into action.
All right, men. Follow me.
Zari's army advances toward the pond, and the life and death battle is about to begin. Meantime, at the mouth of the river, Jonathan and his friends are still waiting for Mr. Eel.
He should have been here long before now. I wonder what's keeping him.
I sure hope he didn't run into any trouble, Ely.
Uh-oh. Oh, my poor father.
What happened to him?
He got caught in the fisherman's dragnet, and there's no way for him to escape.
What? We have to help him, Ely.
There's no way out of a dragnet. Once you're caught, you're done for.
I'm afraid they've got me this time for sure. Unless I can find a hole somewhere in this net, I'm done for.
Zari's army continues its ominous advance toward the pond, but their movements have not gone undetected.
Mm-hmm. Here they come. Good thing Moon Lefty warned us.
The inspector has assembled a formidable army of his own to defend the pond against the invaders.
Those poor fools don't suspect a thing. We're gonna take them completely by surprise.
Hammond Division, prepare to advance.
We can't handle them without him. Okay, boys, you know what to do.
Hey, what's the big idea? I'm trying to get some sleep.
Our invasion isn't turning out exactly the way we planned it, and we're going to lose the pond if you don't help.
Well, now that I'm awake anyway... I guess I am a little hungry.
Well, there's an army of seafood out there just waiting for you to come and get them. So how about it? Do you think you can get up?
Oh, well, I guess I can if I really have to.
As the fishermen draw the dragnet tighter and tighter and closer and closer to the shore, Mr. Eel tries desperately to find a way out, but to no avail. Meantime, his son Ely attempts to free his father by chewing a hole in the net, but Ely's efforts too appear hopeless.
wish there was some way we could help Ely out.
I feel the same way, Jonathan, but I think all we can do is hope and wait.
Well, I can't just sit here and do nothing.
Now, don't do anything foolish, Jonathan. Frogs can't survive in seawater.
If Mr. Eel can't get away to help us, everyone in the pond will be eaten by the catfish, so we have to get him out of there, no matter how dangerous it may be.
You wouldn't last 10 minutes down there, Jonathan. Don't do it!
Drown him out!
You're crazy, Jonathan! Come back here! Oh, too late.
Ooh. How can I help you?
Huh? Try to make a hole in the net.
Okay.
Thanks, guys!
Jonathan, what's wrong?
Just as Cheaper said, Jonathan could not stand the effects of salt water. Back in the catfish monster's cave, Zari gloats.
Now that we have Bruto to fight for us, that pond is as good as ours.
You know, Zari, I'm really looking forward to this. The first one I'm going to eat is that Leopold character.
All right, you messers, head them up and move them out.
Okay, guys, let's roll out.
Now what? Huh? Let's get out of here.
Hey, what's going on here? Ow! Hey!
Oh, no, retreat, retreat. Help! Go! Well, I guess that's it, man. Bruto's beat us.
Yeah, we've got him.
What are you talking about? He's got us.
We wanted him to swallow us. That's our battle plan.
Oh, well, I don't understand, but if you've got a plan, go ahead with it.
This is the worst stomach ache I've ever had.
Ow! Again! That's it, Inspector. Let him have it.
Keep it up.
Hi!
Oh!
Ah!
Oh, I don't know how much longer I can take it.
Oh! Oh! Hi!
Here, here.
Oh! Ah! Hi!
Hey, it worked. Well done.
It's all over. We'll never know what happened to Jonathan.
Boogie.
Huh?
What?
Jonathan!
Hi, Pookie. I almost drowned, but Mr. Eel brought me around. And he's going to help us get rid of the catfish monster, too.
Uh-oh, an electric eel. This means trouble.
Listen, Zari, if you think I'm going to take him on, you've got another thing coming. You know how I despise electricity.
Don't you worry, I have a plan.
Uh-oh, I wonder what Zari's up to now. Let him have it, Mr. Eel.
Hey,
Jonathan!
We outsmarted you that time, didn't we?
He was your last hope. Nothing will save you now.
Yeah, I appreciate you gathering here together. It's going to make my job a lot easier. Ready or not, here you go!
Just what I need. Come ahead, catfish. I'm ready.
We gotta get him out. He won't live more than 15 minutes in there.
This rock must weigh 40 tons, Ely. It's impossible for us to move it.
Out of my way, you scum.
Hey, watch it, clown.
Clown?
I think you owe me an apology, Zari.
Hey, listen, I don't owe you nothing. I'm taking over.
Huh?
All right, you little two-gooder. I've been looking forward to having a showdown with you for a long time now, and now I've got gotcha. You. You're gonna be sorry for that, you little twerp. How to finish him off? Looks like an earthquake.
Where's that catfish?
Oh no! The electric monster! Help! Get away! Get away! Oh, I gotta get out of here!
Battle formation! We're gonna give that monster some of his own medicine! Charge!
Let's go,
Rainbow Pond joyously celebrate the departure of the catfish monster and the return of peace and friendship to their beloved home. Once again, Rainbow Pond is a place of happiness and brotherhood and love. And of all the people in Rainbow Pond, Pookie and Jonathan are the happiest, for now they see a beautiful future ahead for them. No more danger, no more enemies, just peace and love. truly, Rainbow Pond is now a place where everyone can live happily ever after.